I just knew with a minute of medicine for your mind. I had a friend back in the day, you know, that didn't like BMWs because their mom told him it stood for Black Man's Wish. So I didn't like BMWs because they didn't like them. Until one day my youngest son bought one and he drove up in the driveway and he was proud and happy of his car and he looked good in it. And I realized, you know, there wasn't nothing wrong with the cars, it was something wrong with my thinking. And I could trace that thinking all the way back to someone in my life, just somebody I kicked it with. They weren't even somebody I aspired to be like or had a leadership position over me or anything, just somebody I kicked it with. And they were influencing my decisions for about 25 years of my life. So what am I trying to say to you? It's real simple, see? We all have four gates into our minds. It's our eyes, our ears, our nose, and our mouth. And the cult and the people that we spend our time around and the places we spend our time, that's what we give permission to develop the culture that regulates the things that go in and out of those gates and controls the traffic in our minds and in our hearts. You see, and that'll take place all of our life and control our thoughts and our mind all of our life unless something happens or you do something to change that. For instance, when I saw my son in that car and I realized that there wasn't nothing wrong with the car, I actually realized I can go to the store right then and buy one if I wanted to because I was blessed with those kind of means. But more importantly, I realized that it was up to me. I gave permission to myself of whether I liked that car or not someone else. So I'm encouraging you to regain control of the gates that you have, what goes in and out of them, because when you do that, you then regulate what's traveling through your mind. And if you're regulating what's traveling through your mind, then you're controlling your thoughts and not some random person or some random place that you've exposed yourself to at some time in your life. Besides, I'd hate to see you go 25 years and not admit that you like BMWs. This is Newt with a minute of medicine for your mind.